One night he'd said to me, "Will you leave me all your records when you die?" And I says, "But you don't like my records. You're always saying how crap they are." And he says, "Yeah, I'm going to sell them and get some good ones." I'm Sue Starbuck. Tend to go under the name of Starstruck when I'm DJing, and I DJ currently part as Sussex Stories with Chris Baldwin, who is Giant Ed, and who is doing some amazing stuff at the minute. So if ever you see his playing, I would highly recommend. Then also play as Sisters of Sound, which, as everyone knows, is I do with Sonia Hawkes. Occasionally we do have other lasses join in, but it is all female and it is all vinyl. It was really when I got into Northern Soul. I did have records. They were mainly what my brother and sisters a lot older than me, so I didn't inherited a lot of records. They'd just left them. There were a lot of duplicates because they're both like more or less the same thing, but it was that brother sister thing they didn't share. They had to have their own sort of thing. So I was very lucky I'd got some decent music to start with to listen to. One of the ones being, which I didn't realise I had, it was just I was looking for things to play that I'd not played before at the Jam Caf. And there was this record and it got Hound Dog on it and Big Mama Thornton, and it was like, "Oh, give this a listen." So I put it on and I'm like, "Whoa, why have I never played this before?" So that night puts it on. Nick Keeling came running over. "Oh my God, so where did you get that from? How much did that cost you?" And it was like, "Well, it were either my brothers or my sisters." I says, "I don't know who, you know." I says, "But it's here." And he was like, "God, it must be worth a fortune." It will have no idea, you know. Anyway, I had a look and it was, and it was like, shit. And then I noticed they'd repressed and they'd got some cheaper ones. So I got one of them, let Nick know, and I don't think he were lucky enough to get one because I think they only repressed about 1,000. And I paid a tenner for it, but it were already going up to crazy prices, and it were like, why is people doing this? You know, it's so, that's the other thing I don't like with the sort of, there's so many, you know, people who's got money can afford to just throw big bucks at getting things. And then it makes it sad for people who want to start and collect music because it's pricing things out the market and they can't always get it. Yeah. Yeah, so mine first started with Northern Soul, and it were pricey, but not as pricey as it ended up going, and that was all thanks to people like you, Keb Darge and stuff, who'd got money and paid the money, and it just put things through the roof. Ooh, God, that's going back some. I started at the Bodega. It was by fluke, and it was all thanks to James Bailey. He wanted to set something up where we got selected as staff DJing, and so he asked me to do that bit, which I did, and he said, "Why don't you play?" Because he knew I'd got, you know, records, soul, funk, Northern Soul, things like that. And he was like, "Oh, I'm not a DJ." But I linked up with Natalie, who went out with Gary X-Ray at the time. So we used to play together. And it was absolutely brilliant. But I was just so nervous. So I used to get well bladdered. And then sadly, Natalie, one of the nights we were going to play, her cat had died, so she, you know, obviously didn't want to play. So I got Greg out, the x-rays involved, and oh God, what a night. We'd arranged to meet, both of us in the same bar, total end of different, the same bar. Didn't think about looking around, we just sat and drank, because I think both of us were nervous about doing it. Eventually Greg came through the bar and they were like, oh my God, you're here. So off we trotted and started playing. Really, really drunk, and everybody knows the story of me playing the slipmat, which I think is notorious around Nottingham. But yeah, when everybody was giving it way, I was thinking, oh, they want to hear it again. But yeah, and then it took Martin to come over and say, Sue, you're playing a bloody slipmat, them needles cost a fortune. No idea. I've got things dotted around. There's things in wardrobes, there's things in like boxes down there. They're all over the place. I've been very good at managing to conceal them, but when I need them, sometimes that's a bit of a pain. I mean, really, in the grand scheme of things, compared to other people who DJ and stuff, I've not got that many records, I don't think. But I like what I've got. I mean, I've never bought things really. I have done recently, but in general, I buy things that I like. I don't generally buy things because I'm thinking I can play this out, because I want to listen to it at home, you know. So when I've got things under bed as well, I forgot about them. I like going to Barnsley. I think it's called Vinyl Underground. And yeah, it's just a nice little shop. I always come back with something, you know, that I didn't expect to get. I also like when you go to Manchester, you know, like Piccadilly Records and things like that. They've always got a good selection. And occasionally I buy things from, I think it's called Rap and Soul, and it's a lady called Geraldine, and she is so lovely, and if they've got somewhere, I would love to go to that. And the guys at Norman's Records invited me to go, and you know, because they've got like a warehouse thing, but they've said if you wanted to come along, so I would like to go there sometime. But it's just remembering with me, and also getting the time to go to these places. I mean, one of my worst is going, I like them all, that's the thing. Because that's why I can't get, even though I'll just show you some of the nutty ones that we've got down here. Because there's a background with this. My dad loved Russ Conway. He played the piano. He loved how Russ Conway played, because it was totally different to how anybody else did. It weren't classical. And he only had, was it four fingers? He didn't have a little finger or something on one hand. Can't believe I know this. But what's the record that I love of his? Because there is one I absolutely love. No, can't think. But yeah, so although it's bad, it's good. And then, one that I used to often dig out when people came round, and I don't know if I'll be able to find it, but it's a Scottish one. No, I can't find it, but they might have it here, actually, because I think I've actually got it on CD. Have I? I don't know. No, I haven't. But they're called the Alexander Brothers, and there's one, and it's called Here Are My Mountains, and the version that Basil and James used to do, I don't think you could do it on air, but that really inspired them. Wow.
For these are my mountains, and this is my glen. The braes are my childhood.
I saw a sign in this record shop saying accountant wanted, so I thought I'll pop in and see. So in I went, and they arranged for me for an interview. I turn up, Brian didn't. This happened three times, and then they arranged the fourth one, and I'd said to Jeff, who was the manager at Bridlesmith, I'll come to this one, but if he doesn't show, that's it, I'm not bothering. Anyway, Brian were there, and we spent probably about 2 hours just talking about what I liked, what he liked, where I went, who my friends were, who his friends were. You know, nothing to do with accounts. And he'd already said, I don't know about accounts, that's why I need somebody to do this. And off I went, and he said he'd let me know when I'd be starting. And then it was about 7 o'clock one night, a couple of weeks later, and Brian rings up and he was like, so when are you coming into work? And I said, have I got the job? And he says, of course you have. So it all went from there. I don't know what I think I'd say is my favourite record sleeve. I do like Mr. Scruff though, he's always interesting. Yeah, favourite record sleeve, Gordon Bennett, now you're asking. I'll tell you which one I do like though, and this is for a single. And it's Sharon Jones and the
Deptones,
yeah. I just, and it's got a different, that was her, I presume. No, I don't think it, well, it might have been actually, but yeah. But I just thought that was a nice little touch with that single. These were done in Germany. And, what's her name? It's a guy who I know called Anthony. He's played on both of them. He's played bass. But it's Holly Blue. She was involved with this one, but not on that one. But yeah, good albums to check out. Here we've got Tends to Be Soul and Funk. Here we've got R&B and hip hop. Here we've got a bit of ska and stuff. And then it's just random. And then it's random, and it's random. And then we've got metal, I think. These ones. Nick Keeling, I've got your records. So come and get them when you're ready. These ones, they're ones that I've played recently when I've been out. Played recently when I've been out. Played recently when I've been out. And the ones over there. Played recently when I've been out, and down there tends to be a good bit of like your new disco and things like that that I've just started getting into.
Why is it down there? Why is it not made it into the shelf?
Because I can't get it in. I am going to have a culling, because there is things that I think, no, they've got to go, and then they can make it in there. But it's not, I think it's as I buy them, they just get left here, there and everywhere. I've no need to pull these out because these were here. But I've just bought them too. This was DJ'd by, recommended by a guy called Dave Mack, who, oh God, why aren't I mentioning this? If you're into ska, lip soul, anything like that, Dave is an amazing DJ. But you've got also got Andrew, and you know Andrew, I think.
Neil.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he's going to be doing a night on, I think it's the 11th of December, and it will be awesome because the speakers he's got and everything is amazing. But this was something I wouldn't have thought Dave would be into, and he recommended that. Good. Got the DJ Yoda because Sonia, who I DJ with, she absolutely loves him, and it is, it's lovely. But it's a different one to sort of, I mean, he has got Beardy Man on, which, you know, I think them two are friends. But it's a bit like a, well, it's described as a, I think it was described as a prom album. Oh, it is prom night. So, yeah, it is. But, yeah, I just, as always, his stuff's really good. something, not an Elvis fan, but I watched the film when I was coming back from Reykjavik, and I'd already heard the Doja Cat version of Hound Dog, and it's fantastic. But equally, most of the tracks have been remixed and they've all sort of got a bit of a hip-hop edge. So I do like the music from that one. 7 Day Lover. I love playing that record. That's single, yeah, but I think the easiest one I'll be able to... can I? Oh, it is that one that I've got that's in here, because I didn't take any of the originals with me, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to find it. And it might not be in these, because it could... I'll tell you what I love at the minute. At the minute, Gabriel's Love and Hate in a Different World. Oh, my God. When I first got it, I just couldn't stop playing it. And, well, I'm still the same. Love it. But I tend to, whatever is my record, and I like this one as well. This is a one that's sort of a funky, sort of maybe is, I don't know if it was played on the sort of soul funk side of Northern. And it I can't tell you who the original did, but this is a cover version of it. And I just like this version. I've got the original somewhere.
What
and
is it, sorry?
It's called Mama's Baby, and then in brackets, Ain't a Baby No More. Well, I think I've named them all. I mean, Giant Head, I think now that everything's lifted, he's done loads of stuff while it's been locked down. So I know Chris will, you know, he'll get some gigs and things. So I would recommend going to see him. I would recommend going to see Midnight Rodeo. From when I saw them play at the first gig to what they're doing now, it's just, yeah, absolutely brilliant. I would say, if you like things a bit more on the heavier scene, I would say Reciprocate, because I would like to see them again. One that I forgot before, there was a gig, and it was Midnight Rodeo were playing the first gig, and then they had, Sanjo Panjo, is it, I think they're called. Yeah, and they are awesome. And, when I saw them not so long back at the Rescue Rooms, again, all of them are just, from being good, they're just getting to be excellent. They was the main support, and then they had a band called Victory Lap, and they just got together. They'd not got anything out there that anybody could listen to. They'd never played a gig, and this was the first one, and it was just like, wow. And I managed to get to see them a few weeks back, well, probably a couple of months back, and again, they've just come on amazing. Casper, who's in Do Nothing, which Do Nothing, I mean, they're getting lots of publicity on Radio 6. Yeah, he's also in this band called Divorce, or I think he is, because when I saw him the other week, he weren't actually playing, so I don't know if he were ill and they'd got somebody else in, or if he's actually left them. But Tiger, who fronts it, her voice is just so unusual. Yeah, absolutely love seeing them. I know there's others as well. Christmas, a good one.
Joyful Sound.
Yeah.
What's that?
It's a Christmas album.
What's that?
Low, have you never heard this one?
No.
Oh my God.
Christmas collector, really,
this, well, I do like to get some nice Christmas one, but this is just beautiful. And whenever we go to Stewart's, if I'm the one who gets to put the records on first, well, it's either that one or that one. But actually, I don't think Stuart's got it on vinyl. It might only be CD, but yeah, lovely album. These came from Dorothy, who was Brian's wife. We sometimes meet up, and she asked me, did I want them? And they used to be in the shop, and it was like, oh my God, yeah. And then I've got them, and it's like, oh, what am I going to do with them all? So Totty is staying with me, but these two little beauties have got a nice home with my friend Stuart. Nick's mum did and dad did this, and I can vouch every single, well, I haven't done every single one, but I've done majority of the recipes. There were a few I didn't do because they'd got meat in them, but this is an amazing book. So you should buy it for Christmas for everybody.
Right, I'll give you a check at the end.